All right, YouTubers, how you diddling? This is the Disposalist, and this will be my 12th guide for Battlefield 1. In this video, I'm going to talk about transport vehicles. That is armored cars, scout cars, motorcycle and sidecars, and the torpedo boats. Good start. Okay, this is the armored car. This is just one variant of them, but all armored cars behave in the same way. If I leap in, I'll get into the driver's position. There's nothing the driver can do except drive. You can move between third person and first person view. In the second position, you have control of the turret, which is a zoomable heavy machine gun. In third position, you have a zoomable light machine gun, which has a good range of view, forward facing, nearly 180 degrees forward facing. In the fourth position, we've got a side pointing light machine gun, and the same in the fifth, but on the right hand side. That is pretty much it for the armored car. This is the motorcycle and sidecar unit. As with the other transport vehicles, there are various different models, but they all have the same functionality. As the driver, in position one, you can swap between first and third angle there, first and third person. And you can look all around yourself while you're riding, which is handy for keeping an eye on the enemy, but a bit dangerous for the actual riding. The thing to note for the motorcycle and sidecar is it's the fastest unit, aside from aircraft, in the game. Even faster than the cavalry. But, whoa, as you can see there, it's a little difficult to control at speed. You really want to try and keep speed down when you want to do your maneuvers. Use the speed for long distance straight lines, really. Otherwise, you're going to quickly get in trouble. Although you can use that slide and skid maneuver once you learn how to do it to brake and turn to kill the speed and enable a quick turn. Yeah, I'm not really expertly showing you that. In the second position, your passenger there can fire sidearms. First things, you can throw out your gadgets. I have found this occasionally bugs, and I don't know under what conditions it does, but you sometimes cannot use your gadgets fire and fire your weapons. This is your scout vehicle, and once again, as with the other transport vehicles, there are different models, but they all have the same characteristics. If I climb in here, it's one thing to note for these transport vehicles, you can climb in different locations. If you want to drive, you've got to climb in the driver's seat side. If you climb in the back, you will end up on the position 2 machine gun. This can actually be used against aircraft reasonably successfully. People don't often do that, but if your anti-aircraft is down, you can leap in the back of one of these transport vehicles and fire on the aircraft. I believe it works against smaller vehicles as well. Position three, is the passenger, and you can use your primary and secondary weapons. I believe I've also seen this bug out where you cannot do that, but I can't reproduce exactly the condition, so it must be some sort of random bug. And of course, in position one, you are driving in either first person or third person view. Now, the scout cars are not very well armored. A couple of light anti-tank grenades will take them out. They steer reasonably well. You might not believe that from my driving here, but they do. But they aren't all-terrain vehicles. Be careful not to get them stuck. That was nice. So I think I mentioned earlier that the transport scout car, the rear gun, can be used to damage vehicles. See, it has an effect on this behemoth quite nicely. Definitely worth joining in if you get the chance. I'm going to try and damage the mid part. If I can get that part damaged message effect at this point on the behemoth, I'll probably finish it off. See, the range is pretty good. Still doing damage at this range is really quite nice. Well, I didn't finish him off myself, but I helped. And I'm including the torpedo boat as a transport vehicle. It's a little bit different than the others in that you can spawn directly into it, but you can see that what I'm spawning in as, the choices I have to customize are the four infantry classes. So once you get out of the boat, that's what you will be. But when you spawn in the boat, you are that boat's captain, pilot, driver, whatever you want to call it, coming in first person. You can, of course, change to third person, and you can look all around yourself with this boat, which is quite handy. The weapons you have are the two torpedoes. They act as you might expect. They run along the top of the water and impact upon it, whatever they hit. And you can kill people on shore if they're close enough. One thing to note with those torpedoes is if you fire them at something very close, so if your enemy boat gets close to you and you fire them, they will actually drop under that boat to begin with. They don't rise up to the surface and impact a boat, at the right level to impact a boat, for quite a few meters in front of your boat. So that's your driver. The second position there is this autocannon. This is the same sort of autocannon that you see elsewhere on the front of bombers or in some stationary emplacements. And this autocannon, I think it's a little bit lower caliber than the autocannons you'd see on a tank, but it still does do some light vehicle damage and does quite a lot of damage to infantry and some splash damage as well, so it's not too difficult to hit infantry. It's quite effective. Positions 3 and 4, we've got a machine gun, a heavy machine gun there. I think it's quite an early overheat compared with, say, stationary emplacement machine guns. But it has that shield, which is a bit of a double-edged sword. You can't see a lot through it, but it's good protection while you're using them. The other thing to note with these boats, when you're the pilot, is that they have a bit of off-road functionality. If you get up to a nice speed, they will keep moving over a sandbank like this, fall into the water the other side, and you can keep going. And something some people don't realise, if your pilot grounds it, but you want to take it on an extended trip, you can hit it with your melee weapon to knock it back into the water. And with a bit of scraping on the sand, we're off. The enemy dreadnought has just deployed, so we have an opportunity to show you the torpedo boat in action. There's an enemy torpedo boat coming for us. I'm just going to back off so that I can fire my torpedoes. He's fired his too early and missed me completely. Now we should be able to easily take them.
An enemy dreadnought has arrived.
Gunners do not appear to want to.
We have lost objective Butter.
There we go. That's how to use them torpedoes. That boat was just close enough for those torpedoes to hit. If it had been any closer, then my torpedoes would have just gone under it and harmlessly passed it by. Now I'm really going to take on the dreadnought. Taking the dreadnought on with torpedo boats, the thing to do is to keep your distance, because its AA guns are actually very effective against the torpedo boats. Now I should be able to hit him with torpedoes from about this distance. The way I judge it is that the behemoth mast is about the same as mine. Now I've got to aim, as he's moving, I've got to aim forward, and now I'm going to shoot off sideways. I expect his AA guns to open up on me. So I did hit him, he turned, and the second torpedo missed. I'm going to keep going, I've got to get some distance from him. He's a bit close to me, AA gun-wise. I seem to be beyond the distance of his AA guns there. You can see that they're exploding beyond me, so I now should be able to shoot my torpedoes at him without his AA guns taking me out. Go. So we're doing some damage and his AA guns can't reach me. And it's unlikely that he will turn towards me at this stage. His AA is keeping firing on me. But it's not going to work. Now that big explosion to my right there, I believe that was his big guns. He was trying to hit me with his big guns there. I don't know if he's too far, but I don't think my last round of torpedoes hit him.
We have taken objective Charlie.
So I'm going to move parallel to him. Yeah, my torpedoes just hit. To keep far enough away from his AA guns. Torpedoes have reloaded. Fire two more. And keep parallel to him. So I keep my distance. Keep putting those hits in. Still keeping trying to hit me. It's a little bit fruitless, guys. You might want to concentrate on the shore. In fact, I was going to say, his AA guns keeping trying to hit me is actually an advantage to me. It lets me know exactly how far away he is and how far away I need to be. A lot of guys will swear at the second gunner doing his thing, but that second gun actually does, the AT cannon on the front does actually do damage against the behemoth. My passenger wants to get on that gun, it will damage the behemoth, and I don't mind him letting the behemoth know where I am, because I'm out of range anyway. Getting a bit close. Move away at a bit of an angle. There we go. I think I've damaged most of the mid parts. I need to try and aim ahead of him. He's still moving forward. Because every time on a behemoth you get a part damaged, a big chunk of health comes off, as well as the normal damage that you just did. I'm going to aim in the very front. He's not moving now. Hopefully that damage will stay. Front.
We have lost.
Oh, I have an enemy boat attacking me. I just heard a torpedo. Oh, there he is. I've got a torpedo boat after me, so I'm going to have to take that on now. It's going to get tricky. That's close. My gunner is not looking. Why is he firing that machine gun? He should have been on the front 80 cannon. That takes out enemy boats real quick. So thanks for watching, YouTubers. Leave me a thumbs up if you like the video. Leave me a thumbs down if you must. Please do leave me comments. I love to hear your thoughts and your suggestions for other videos, especially if you make your own. See you next time. Cheers.